Every once in a while, a revolutionary product used to come. We just changed the complete industry and everything. I'm very fortunate to invent one such innovation, selector sub, which has just not solved the selector's problem, while just in a month it has changed the complete industry of XPath and CSS selectors and became the number one tool. Today I'm going to show you all those amazing innovations in selectors of 2.0, and here in this video I will show you like step by step all the features and everything, how to use it, what all amazing innovations it has in very detail. My name is Sanjay Kumar. I am the creator of selectors of and CrowPath. So let's just start how to download and everything. So it's very simple and straightforward. How can we install it? And it is available for all the browsers, Chrome, Firefox, Edge and Opera. So whichever browser you want, you can follow the same steps what I'm going to show in this video. And it is very straightforward and very simple. And I have really worked hard on this to make similar functionality on all the browsers. So there's nothing changed. You will always get the same functionality, everything same, with the same version on all the browsers. So let's say, yeah, I will give a demo on Chrome browser. So to install it on Chrome, just click on this Chrome download icon. Here it will open the selector sub. Click on add to Chrome, add extension. So once it is added, you can find that by default on Chrome now you will not find the logo here. So what you do, you just click on this default extension icon and then click on pin extension. So now it will come on toolbar. So now you would be able to see, you can see the instruction and everything here, and more details you can always find here on the Chrome Web Store page as well, like version update, updated date and everything. And here are all the descriptions and everything. You will get the latest update and everything here, and of course like more details and everything, updated things, everything, you will get it here in the website. So once you install the selector sub, so we installed it successfully, and there is no dependency on the browser version or any other plugin or anything. It's a very simple single click install, you have seen. Like, so we have installed it, we found it here, it is there in the browser, everything is fine. Once you install it or add it in your browser, I would really recommend you to restart your browser to make it like make the best use of it. It is required once only, not every time you will have to. So, or you just like whichever tabs are already open, you just refresh them so that like it gets the fresh DOM and everything, it works together perfectly. Now, many questions, like many times it has been always like, let me just ask a very simple question, which in fact has been asked to me in all the webinars, all the meetups and whatever session I have taken, workshop till today. It was always asked that whether we should use the CSS selector or XPath. Is it CSS selector better or XPath is better? And is there any performance issue, any performance difference between XPath and CSS selectors use? Even though like it is always recommended that we should use CSS selector, but we always fall in like using XPath. The problem with that is why we always used to fall like by using XPath, because we are not able to write the relative CSS selectors most of the time, and we XPath has a lot of functions which helps us to write the like better relative XPath, and a lot of XPath functions are there, so which makes it easy to write the selectors using XPath functions. So that is one of the reason that we used to use XPath. We have to use the XPath. But today here I'm going to introduce you a new term, relative CSS selector, which will solve your problem. Now just in like a single click, you will get the relative CSS selector, which is very, very helpful. Like you just right click and inspect, and you see that on the right side of the dev tools, like left side you will get the DOM, on the right side you will get the selector sub tab here. And if you didn't find it anywhere, like when you open dev tools and you find that it is not visible here, So make sure on the left side is DOM. On the right side you will find the sidebar. So this used to be called as sidebar. So styles, computed, event, listener, DOM. So all these are there. So after this properties, accessibility, there will be two arrow icons. So either you click on these two arrow icon and you will find the selector sub over there, or you just expand this. Selector sub will be the last step. Here you click on this, and now you see that in a single click, just in a single click, you get all types of selectors along with the relative CSS selector here, which is really amazing. Relative CSS selector, you see that this is the one, relative CSS selector, and this is the relative XPath, name, class name, and everything, and JSPath, absolute XPath, tag name. I will explain all of them, what are there, what all these things, what all everything. So this is occurrences, it is showing here. This is the like what kind of selector it is. So relative CSS selector, this you can directly use it in your script. Like, it is really helpful for means for everyone, for all the web automation engineer, for the web developers, and everyone you can use this as a CSS selector in their script. And it's, of course, like, it is always better than XPath anytime. And if same thing you copy it from like same value, if you try to copy from DevTools, you will find that it is always like whatever selector sub will suggest, always that will be better than the value what you will copy from the Chrome DevTools. You see that this is the value we are getting from the Chrome DevTools for a selector, and this is the value what selector sub is suggesting. So of course it is far better than that, right? So this is really amazing. It is really helpful for all the JS kind of frameworks, like Cypress is really evolving, all the like WebDriver IO, and any of the framework where people cannot write just XPath, they have to go for with a CSS selector. So there it is going to really helpful, really really helpful. Considering all those things, I have invented this and introduced this and put a lot of effort creating relative CSS selector. So I hope this will really help you. Next comes like yes, we know that relative CSS selector, relative XPath, of course it gives the amazing and one of the best relative XPath you can compare with any other tool out there in the market. You will always find this is a really unique, robust, and the best XPath which could be possible to generate it for any element. Like if you click any of these elements, you will find that relative CSS selector, relative XPath, along with that it will also suggest whether it is dynamic or not dynamic. So all those amazing features are here, which will really help you to understand the importance of them and what are those things, everything. It will help you with that, and it will always give you one of the best XPath. Then question comes, like developers used to ask, like, can we also get the JS path? Like if you right click here and you see that it used to give you the JS path as well. But the JS path, what from Chrome DevTools you will get. You see that what value, let's say copy JS path. This is the JS path we are getting from Chrome DevTools. And for the same element, you see what JS path we got it from selectors. This is really helpful for the developers. They can directly use it, document.query selector and this value, and this is really helpful. This is what we got from Chrome DevTools. This is what selectors is giving. So this is really helpful. And to copy these values, you see here it is, you just click on these header, whichever value of whichever kind of selector you want to copy, you just click on this value will be copied. Like relative XPath, you want to copy this, just click on this header, relative XPath header. So here I have optimized the space by not having like so many icons, like copy icon, edit icon, such, I mean not jargon. So I really try to make it advanced and using the space, because here we have the very small space, like there's many people open, like very small in this kind of thing. So it is going to really helpful, like, and you need not to just carefully hover on those icons as well. So you just click on this to copy any of whichever value, respective value you want, click on those selector setup, and to edit any of these value, of course, so you always used to click on that value, right? So you just click, it will copy and paste the value here. So anywhere on the value, if you will click, it will copy paste, and you can edit and verify at the same time. So this is going to be really helpful. And there are a bunch of amazing features. So let's say here it is generating with title, but you want with some other attribute. Let's say we want with here we want to generate the XPath with some other attribute. Let's say we want with here with let's say name we want. So you just pass the name here and hit enter. It will generate the with your attribute whatever you have passed. Also, like if you let's say by default it has generated with some class here, it has generated, you just uncheck the class here, it will generate with some other attribute. So that option is really helpful here. Then if you want to let's say even if you want to use this in your script, right, but you don't want to, in fact you didn't want to write that command as well, like find elements command, so that also you can append here. Click on this set driver command and here you can just pass the value whatever command you have in your framework, like find by XPath, and here wherever you used to write the like XPath, wherever in your command you just replace that XPath with XPath value keyword and hit enter. It is really smart to like append that and generate that command. So here you see that find by CSS selector, find by XPath, class name and everything it will generate here. So this you can directly use it in your script. Now you can copy value and paste it in your script, and at any point of time you don't want to use it, just turn it off, it will be away. And anything like any setting you can, like you don't want to see this as well, so UI is very customizable as per your requirement, so you can also turn off this one. So you see, and any of the settings, like whatever you have done, like this is what you have set your UI view of selector. So if you close this and reopen it, it will open with your view what you have set. So it is really really helpful, like whatever you will set it will come with the same similar view next time when you will open, and if you want anything so that you can open. So its UI is really customizable, very optimal, all the types of selectors, all the information, and very neat and clean. Now what all amazing things are here, really amazing things are here. You can also use it as an editor, like the very first taglines of selectors have used to say that build your own XPath and CSS selector in less than 5 seconds. So like I said, selectors have really helps you a lot to write your own XPath, build your own XPath, to have a lot of good learning. Like you did not to waste your time, like you will learn a lot, and you will not have to waste that much time while copying the value from here and then paste it in your like while writing the XPath or CSS selector. You see how you just start typing here, you will see that it auto suggests that like how many text input tags are there, whatever element you have inspected immediately used to show them here, and that you just keep typing. It is the like something like a smart intelligence. Like in a smart intelligence or like a smart editor, whenever we start typing our code, they used to suggest the auto suggest the functions, right? So similarly it used to suggest the functions if when you start typing here. You can select here and you can verify like this. So this is really fast. You just type like this and there you go. And if you have to like make anything like preceding siblings, following siblings, so this is really amazing and really helpful. It has all those functions. Like we have done this, as soon as you type forward slash, it will suggest that preceding siblings, if preceding siblings possible, like whatever ancestors are possible, whatever types of ancestors are possible, it will suggest them. You can select them, and now we want like preceding siblings, here is input, you can type this input here and there you go, it will give you, we have written the XPath for that. So this is really amazing and really helpful. You can also like you can also turn it off. Let's say you don't want to get these auto suggested auto generated XPath, many people doesn't want, so you can just keep it, turn it off, and you see that it's very simple now. And there you go, you just start typing here and build your own XPath within few seconds like this. And you see there you can add the and condition or condition, whatever you want you can add it, and at any point of time it also suggests the, it also have the feature to like it supports index basically, so it is finding two matching node. At any point you didn't find the unique XPath, you just put the cursor in the beginning open parenthesis and it will suggest you the unique XPath with the indexes for that element. This is really amazing. And as we have set the off, turned off the auto suggest feature, so it will save you, it will save your setting in the local. So if you will open selector sub next time, it will open with your own setting. So isn't it amazing? Isn't it really helpful? And at any point of time you can just turn it on. There you go. So simple and so useful. It also highlights the matching elements here, and it also suggests all the matching nodes. It will also give you them. It also gives you whenever you will hit something, let's say you are trying to verify some XPath or CSS selector, so it will always give you, it will always suggest you the better selector. Whatever you have, you are typing here, you are verifying, it will always suggest the unique selector for that, for the very first matching node. So let's say for an example, you have copied the value from here, copy selector, let's say, and you just paste that selector here and hit enter. Selectors will suggest you the better selector for your selector. So you see, this is the CSS selector, and same selector sub is suggesting for that. So this you can use in place of this. So isn't it really incredible and amazing? Indeed, this is just wow, and it's really helpful. Moving on, what all other really unique features which you would have never seen and never experienced in automation industry or in selectors industry. So shadow DOM feature. It was never possible to write and verify or generate the XPath or CSS selectors for shadow DOM elements, and in fact we were never able to understand whether shadow DOM elements are we can write the XPath for shadow DOM elements and whether this element is inside shadow DOM or not. Many people doesn't understand. In fact, I was not aware about shadow DOM quite for sometimes, around 4 months back I learned about shadow DOM. You see that as soon as you open selector sub, immediately it tells you that this element is in shadow DOM, and this is the relative CSS selector for this, and all that information, this element is inside shadow DOM, so for such elements XPath won't support, so we cannot write the XPath. This is really amazing. And in fact, if you see that, let me copy this value and paste it in here in DevTools. Chrome DevTools doesn't support shadow DOM to verify selectors for shadow DOM. You see it is showing 0 of 0. It was really, really big pain for all the people out there. And if you inspect here, if you inspect or whatever you want, you just do, and you would be able to create as well. You just put dot here, it will suggest the CSS selector. If it has ID, you just type hashtag, you would be able to get that CSS selector, and press enter. So this is really helpful. This is really amazing. It was never possible with any tool. This is the only tool, selector sub is the only tool which suggests and which supports shadow DOM elements. Then we have questions SVG elements. I'm sure many of you are aware that we cannot write the standard format of XPath for shadow DOM elements, right? So how to write the XPath for shadow DOM for SVG elements? SVG elements doesn't support the XPath standard format. We have to write it in different format. In fact, if I inspect this element, let's say this element is SVG icon, right? So if you right click and copy this value what DevTools used to give and paste that, it is showing 0 of 0, single forward slash. This doesn't support. Same value, you see that it gives you the correct XPath, relative XPath, CSS selectors and all these possible selectors for this SVG element, which is possible and with the standard format of SVG. So you see that this XPath, it has the double forward slash colon local name is equal to SVG. We cannot write the double forward slash SVG kind of XPath for SVG element. In fact, even if you paste it here, it will tell you what is there, what is not there. And if you write this SVG, it will also suggest you this is invalid SVG XPath format, invalid XPath. You can also click on this to learn more. So this is really amazing and really helpful. you will find that here. And in fact, like if you want to build your own XPath, so you just start typing, it will start suggesting you the correct one. And if you want to build with index, anytime you can do that. So this is really helpful, really amazing for you. Then moving on, like iframes. So if you see that here on this is test project website here, if you see, this is one of the really good community product which is absolutely free. You must try it on. So you see that in this page, if we inspect any of the element here, so after, make sure like after adding the selector sub, you have refreshed the restarted the browser or refreshed the pages which were open already. So you see that it immediately tells you that this is SVG icon. Now let's talk about the iframe. Yes, selector sub supports the iframe as well. As soon as you will inspect the element which are inside iframe from the same source iframe, it will suggest you, it will tell you that this element is inside iframe, iframe selector. It will tell you the iframe selector as well, like inside which this element, inspected element exists. It gives you the XPath for that as well as for this element. This is really, really cool and really amazing. Now you need not to waste the time to find out whether the element is inside iframe or not, and what is the XPath of the iframe as well. Everything you got it from here itself, and you just click on this, one by one, of course, copy this value and paste it in your script, and directly you can use it. If iframes are from different source, so that of course I'm sure like you are aware that we cannot write or inject the script inside those kind of iframes. So cross origin iframes are not possible. Definitely iframe from the same source, yes, it will support iframe, frame, it will support all of them. Now there is a big question, like suppose if something is wrong in our XPath, if something is wrong in our selector, who will help us? How can we solve that problem? Let's say we are trying to write some XPath here, or let me just show here. We have pasted some value here, and by mistake we missed something in our XPath. So here it is showing 0 of 0, right? You see that this one. Let's copy the same value here and put it in selector sub. Many people ask this question, that is there any kind of compiler? So yes, selector sub is the only compiler which gives you the proper error message. What is missing in your selector? You see that it is telling you that close square bracket is missing. You just add that and press enter. There you go. You, if something is missing, it will tell you like what is missing, what is possible, what is not possible. It is really helpful for you to learn more. It will tell you that add tag name after forward slash, what is wrong you are doing, what is possible, what is not possible. It will tell you everything. If you, let's say we have added a tag name after closing a square bracket, it tells you that what is allowed, what is not allowed. This is really, really helpful for you to learn more about DOM, to learn more about selectors. And this is the only possible, only solution, like only compiler or only tool which gives you the proper error message with the missing elements. So this is really, really helpful. And like this, there are a bunch of amazing features, and you won't believe like what all amazing features are there. Then we have you have seen so far that I have to, like, we have to open every time selector sub. Many people doesn't want to open every time, they just want the XPath, like you just right click and we want to copy this. So yes, here it is, and this feature has been implemented like very innovatively. So here you see that by default we are getting copy relative XPath, CSS selectors and everything. You just click on it and the value will be copied in your clipboard. Let me show you again. You just right click and copy anything like we have copied from here. So you just, let me paste it here. So this is the value, like directly we got the value from here. And if you doesn't want to like see all of them, like right now it is showing all types of selectors here in the, but you, let's say you don't want absolute, you doesn't want absolute XPath, JSPath, relative CSS, you just want the relative XPath only, because unnecessarily why to waste time like generating these. Stop, let selectors up, don't generate this and doesn't want to waste that time. So you go here, click on this selector sub icon from the toolbar, and you just uncheck these values. this is really, really amazing. You can configure your settings, your view, what you want to see, what you don't want to see. You just right click, come here, you see that only one option, copy your device path, and there you go. I'm feeling lucky. Isn't it amazing? It's really amazing. And in fact, like, you doesn't want the context menu on the right click, you just turn it off. Boom, there you go, it is not there. And when, like, for the next time, for any other website, if you will open it, will open with your default settings, what you have set. So like, let's say next time you are opening google.com, it will open with your default setting, like it will not come that there. So it saves your setting in the local, so you need not to worry about that. And at any point of time you can turn it on and you just enjoy using it. There you go. So this is really, really amazing and really helpful for you, and it will save a hell lot of time for you. And as much as you will explore Selectors Hub, you will fall in love with it, you will really love it. And I would really request you, like, please, so this is one of the reason that it is not, you are not seeing that value, because this is the page I haven't refreshed after adding it, so it will show like this. So once you after installation, so that is the reason that sometimes we forgot to refresh one of the page here which were already open. So this is just one time setup. After adding plugin, just restart your browser once. After that it will work forever, like very smooth and without any problem. So and keep exploring Selectors Hub. To copy the box value, just click on this, copy will be value will be copied. I would really request you, please check out all these footer icons at any point of time. These has amazing information. I keep adding them. So like, if you are facing any challenge while using Selectors Hub, please connect with me on Selectors Hub Slack channel here. So here we have the very good community already, like so many people have been added here in Selectors Hub just in a month. So you will get immediate response from me or from someone. If you want to learn more about XPath and CSS Selector, click on this. We watch the video tutorials, always like updated video tutorials I will add here. So you can also, I would really recommend you and request you to please subscribe to this YouTube channel as well, Selectors Hub, so that because I'm going to not just about the Selectors Hub video, I'm going to upload the series on XPath, how to write XPath, how to write relative CSS selectors, how to write CSS relative XPath, everything. So all those videos I'm going to upload, so it will be really helpful. So you can subscribe to the channel. You can also direct link from here you will get. If you face if you got any bug or any feature improvement you want here, any new feature, please raise issue or raise an PR here on GitHub. Please check out the FAQs whenever you are going to raise any issue or anything in GitHub. Before that you can have a look at FAQs as well. I would really request you, and my humble request, please add a review for Selectors Hub and share with your team and with colleagues on social media, and let them know about this amazing innovation and help the community. I'm full time working for the community, I'm not working for any company, and this is the like only motivation. Your reviews, your support is the only motivation for me to work on this free innovation, free product, full time for you guys. And I would really recommend you, like, if you really Selectors Hub is really helping you and saving time for you in your job and in your learning, and if you feel that you should donate and support, so I would really request you, please donate for Selectors Hub. If you are like outside India, please donate through PayPal. If you are in India, you can directly pay me through Paytm, GPay or Phone Pay or anything on this number. You can join the Telegram group, Facebook, everything is here. And I would really request you, if it will be really helpful for me if you can be a patron for Selectors Hub and support Selectors Hub. Even if a coffee, like if you can get me per month, that is more than enough for me, like just $1 to $5 if you can donate per month. Just be a patron here. If you click on that link, it will open the Selectors Hub patron page, so there you can be a patron. And with that, I'm really thankful for you. And if you have any feature, anything, feel free to reach out to me And I would again request you, please add the review, share with your community, with colleague, and let them know about this amazing innovation, a new reality. With that, thank you so much for watching. Keep supporting, keep helping, and here I am, and we'll keep innovating and a lot more amazing features in the pipeline. With that, thank you so much.